everybody, Tom Barnes for the Chicago Scene down at University Park at Governor State University. I'm here in their Performing Arts Center, which happens to be celebrating its 25th anniversary, and the executive director of the Performing Arts Center, Lana, is besties with Bruce of Alligator Records. Yes, that blues label celebrating 50 years of making music here in Chicago and the world. And they're besties, so they decided to throw a little party to celebrate both. So that's where I'm at. So I'm gonna talk to Bruce, I'm gonna talk to Lana about how this whole thing got started and get a little sneak peek inside of some of blues legends that are coming right here out of Chicago. That's the Chicago Scene for right now. So let's go say hi to Bruce and Lana. All right, let's go. All right, I've made my way inside the Performance Center and I'm here with Lana and Bruce. Hi guys, how are you?
Hi.
Great, thank you.
And so Bruce, real quick before I chat with Lana, this is your company that's been around for 50 years. What does that mean for you as far as sticking around in the music business, A, and B, doing it blues style in Chicago?
Well, I got into the music business specifically because I was a blues fan. I came to Chicago for the blues and I started Alligator Records to record some of Chicago's great blues artists. Over the years, it's actually expanded to record some of the world's great blues artists, but of course some of the very best are here in Chicago and performing on this show.
Right, so real quick, Lana, the show kind of started with you and Bruce talking after an event that you guys were at, and then you kind of met up to talk about what you wanted this event to be, to celebrate both the university's anniversary and Alligators, right?
There was a spark. Okay. As we realized that our 25th anniversary and Bruce's 50th anniversary happens exactly the same year. So we decided, why not make a big party and merge our efforts? We envision it as a beautiful, lively celebration of the blues with great roster of Bruce's artists on our stage, but it didn't exactly happen that way. Because of the pandemic, we had to pivot a bit. And we considered canceling the event, and we considered postponing the event, but after all, we thought that, you know, in this year, more than any time, people need the beautiful healing sounds of the blues to bring us together, and the artists need to be paid.
For sure, yeah. I mean, the industry has suffered greatly just because of the lack of live music. And this event, Bruce, is something to not only celebrate them, celebrate music, celebrate Governor State, but everything involved. So who might see during this live event? And what's it called, just so we get that out there?
Well, it's the Alligator 50th anniversary and Governor State 25th anniversary celebration. And Billy Branch and the Sons of Blues, who are one of the best blues bands in Chicago, which means, of course, one of the best blues bands in the world.
Absolutely.
Because Chicago is the world capital of blues, are acting as the band for everybody. Billy will be doing his own set, and then there'll be guest appearances by Toronto Cannon, Chicago's CTA, bus-driving
blues. Steve Sanders has done quite a bit with him over the years at WGN, so we're familiar with him for sure, yeah.
And Little Ed of Little Ed and the Blues Imperials, who's been on Alligator since the mid-1980s and is a premier slide guitar player. And then finally, the young queen of the blues, Shamika Copeland, who is was crowned by Coco Taylor's daughter on the stage at the Chicago Blues Festival and is the premier female blues artist, I would say, in the world these days.
Lana, what's this mean for the university to have this event happening here?
It's exciting. It's exciting on an institutional level. It's exciting on a personal level to hear the sounds of the live music in our venue that has been empty for a year.
Yeah, this is either putting students, faculty, I mean, there's putting people back to work or just being in a building that hasn't been in
Absolutely.
A while, right?
Absolutely. Governor State University Center for Performing Arts, over the 25 years, brought incredible artists and celebrated our stage. And we've been known as a cultural destination in the Southland that embraces the sounds of the blues and jazz and gospel and all the other genres in our state-of-the-art 1171-seat theater. But it's not a coincidence that Bruce and I have connected here because over the past 25 years, we have had the artists like B.B. King, the artists like Billy Branch, the artists like Coco Taylor, artists that are known in Chicago, artists that also share the blues label.
Yeah, and I imagine when things start to open back up again, you know, these blues artists will get back out there. But this is something for them to kind of tide them over. I mean, I imagine this might be the first time that some of these bands have actually played together during the pandemic.
It's been very difficult for the artists, and they're so excited to be here. And you know, the blues community, it's not just a bunch of musicians. These are people who have become close personal friends who go out and sit in and jam with each other on nights when they're not getting paid to play professionally. So this is exciting. It's fun for the musicians. And for me, I haven't seen any of these people for a year. I've talked to them on the phone. I've seen them by Zoom. But
which is very different for you, right? You're with these guys. Like you said, these are family. So it's crazy not to see them.
It's absolutely like family, and I go out so many nights a week normally to hear live music. You know, this is what feeds my soul, and it's going to, of course, will feed the souls of the people who see the show.
So where are you going to go when things open up, Bruce? Like, where is one of the live venues that you're really missing that you want to see, besides stuff that happens here at Governor's, but in the city, where else?
Well, first of all, I want to see the Chicago Blues Festival come back. You know, I've been involved with that from literally day one of the planning of the very first festival. And it is the biggest blues festival in the world. And we've been missing it a lot. As far as clubs, I don't have any secrets. I go to the clubs that other people go to as well. You know, Blues on Halsted, Kingston Mines, and Buddy Guy's Legends, Roses, Fitzgerald's out in Berwyn, Space in Evanston. Yeah. You know, there's more live blues performed in Chicago than any other city in the world. And that's why the musicians get so good, because they're competing for those club gigs, and they've got to be at their best at all times.
Hi, Jane. So where can people find this, and how, and does it cost anything? Give me all those good things.
Sure. So people can purchase tickets online at centertickets.net. That's Center Tickets with an S. And tickets start at $25. This will premiere on the Center's YouTube channel on Saturday, March 13th at 7 p.m. Go to centertickets.net and get your tickets. And this will be available on demand through April 11th.
Perfect. And Bruce, people, for anybody that just wants to find stuff on the on any of the artists at Alligator, what's the website?
Just alligator.com.
And the same thing for like the social media stuff at Alligator Records?
Yes.
Perfect.
And Lana is nice enough to be holding up a copy.
Oh, yeah. We're going to get right over here.
That I co-wrote with Patrick Roberts and has been out for about 2 years on University of Chicago Press, and is, I hope, a very entertaining read and tells people why they should be excited to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the label.
Perfect. Thanks a lot, guys. I appreciate it. And here's to another 50 years and another 25 years plus for you guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. See you. Well, there you have it. 50th anniversary of Alligator Records here at Governor State, premiering March 13th. And it'll be on demand. Pardon me as I walk out. On demand. Tickets are $20 that you can go on to the website right now, tbarnas at wgntv.com. That's tbarnas at wgntv.com if you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene. Till then, let's look at this lovely lake right here on campus.